Namaskar to all of you. I'm happy to be here back in Vijayawada. Today the situation in the country is such that we have a central government which is in a state of denial as far as the realities of the economy is concerned. I read in the papers today, and all of you must have seen, that the international agency, which the Modi government is always happy to quote when it gives them certificates, that international agency has said that the Indian economy has moved from stable to negative. As far as we are concerned, as the people of India are concerned, we know that the Indian economy in our country is experiencing a recession. And today I would like to specifically say that this recession is particularly cruel to India's women. And unfortunately, our finance minister, who also happens to be a woman, is equally in a state of denial and boasting about how well India has done in the last quarter. In fact, on every single economic indicator, it clearly shows that the Modi government has utterly failed to stem the tide and to take policies which will reverse its disastrous steps which have led to this situation. After demonetization, according to all reports, of the 11 million people who lost their livelihood, over 8 million were rural women who lost their livelihood after demonetization. And today, if we see the condition of rural women specifically, and even in the urban sector, we find that incomes, livelihoods are in a deep crisis. At the same time, the increase in inflation in food prices and vegetable prices, even the price of onions, in many parts of India, it is 80 to 90 rupees. So in such a situation, it was duty-bound on the Modi government to take immediate steps to provide the livelihood means for people to overcome this crisis. In rural India, one of the areas was MNREGA, 100 days guarantee work. But the latest figures show that whereas 13 crore plus people applied for work, 2 crore of the 13 crore people were turned back from work. They were not given jobs. Nor were they given any compensation for not giving jobs. This is unprecedented. 13 crore applying for jobs, 2 crore being turned away and not being given jobs. At a time when the demand has to be pushed. After all, how do you get out of recession? You have to increase the purchasing power of the people. Today, 56% of MNREGA workers are women. 56%. But they are not being given work on demand. On the other hand, the government of India is giving concession after concession to big corporates, tax concessions, concessions to the real estate sector, but it does not mean that purchasing power of the people is increasing, because unemployment in the last 45 years, it is highest under the Modi government. So in this economic scenario, we can say that our organizations, the party, CPIM, and all those who are working in different organizations of the people, they are involved in taking up these major issues. One more issue, I would say. Today, there is approximately over 5 crore tons of food grains, 5 crore tons of food grains, which are rotting in government godowns. I remember during the UAPA government time, when a similar situation had arisen, the BJP had said that this is a crime against the hungry people of India. Today, in the World Hunger Index, out of 117 countries, India is at 102. That is a worse record than Pakistan, Bangladesh, Nepal, and Bhutan. All our neighbors and Sri Lanka, all our neighbors have done better in the World Hunger Index. But India, which is at such a state with 5 crore tons of food grains rotting in the godown, they cannot provide it to the people. This is a real shame. And we strongly protest, even today, Aadhaar and biometrics is being used to deprive lakhs of households of their right to food. This also has a very bad impact on women. And just as they are denying the recession in the economy, just as they are denying the unemployment rates which are highest, they are also denying that there is a sexual crime emergency in this country. For 2 years, they tried to hide the report of the NCRB. It is unprecedented. Never before in our history, the National Crime Research Bureau's crime report for India was hidden for 2 years. The last report we had was 2016. The 2017 report has only now been released in 2019. This is a shameful thing. And what does it show? From 2015 to 2017, there was an increase of 38,000 crimes against women. In 2 years, increase of 38,000 crimes. In 2015, the crimes against women were 3.11 lakhs. And in 2017, the crime has grown to 3.46 lakhs. One third of these crimes are committed against minors, of which 1,000 are against children. Children, that is under the age of 10, 1,000 crimes. So, and dowry deaths have increased, and they are now over 10,400. So, in such a situation, the question arises, why is this so? Ramaji has spoken about the experience of Andhra Pradesh and how they are fighting it. Liquor and other issues she has spoken about. A very critical issue is, what is the role of political leaders? What is the role of ministers? What is the role of members of parliament? What is the role of MLAs? Today we have a situation where in the largest country of India, Uttar Pradesh, you have the government going out of its way to stand in protection and to patronize those who are serial rapists. There's an MLA who you know about. Even today, he is still an MLA in the Uttar Pradesh Assembly, having been charge-sheeted for the rape of a minor. Day before yesterday, a most shameful incident occurred when Chinmayanand, who is supposedly Swami, I don't know what kind of swamis we are producing in India nowadays. This Chinmayanand, who is accused of serially assaulting sexually girls of the educational institutions he runs, you in Andhra Pradesh will be shocked to hear he runs approximately 15 to 20 educational institutions under the patronage of Mr. Adityanath's government. He is accused in more than one case against women, and today still he has not been removed from those educational institutions. On the contrary, the young girl who has accused him, her parents were picked up and tortured by the SIT. So, if leaders of the ruling party play such a role in patronizing the criminals responsible or accused of such heinous crimes against young women and girls, naturally this sends a message of impunity to those who are assaulters on women. So this condition of a sexual crime emergency in India, and unfortunately our Home Minister, who is going around the country seeing how much more communal disturbances can be created, he has not uttered a single word even after the NCRB figures were released. I don't think we have seen this kind of a situation earlier. And now Parliament is going to come. The Parliament session has been called. These issues of MGNREGA, the issues of sexual crime, the issues of the economy. But along with that, we demand that in this session of Parliament, the long-pending Women's Reservation Bill should be placed and adopted. This government claims to be looking after women's rights. It boasts that it used its majority to push the triple talaq bill, which affects one section of women in this country. But what about the Women's Reservation Bill? What prevents this government from bringing the Women's Reservation? Only one thing prevents this government. The RSS has been consistently and constantly opposing Women's Reservation Bill on the ideological ground that it will affect the ideal Hindutva family by bringing women away from the home and away from the family. And that is the reason why this government has refused to bring the Women's Reservation Bill. So that is an important demand which we raise. And as far as Andhra Pradesh is concerned, the issues of the women of Andhra Pradesh are as similar to those being faced by the rest of the country. And here our ADWA has been specifically involved in organizing social reform movements using the icons of Andhra Pradesh, the Telugu icons of social reform, to tell those Hindutva forces who want to push women back into the medieval ages that our legacy is social reform, anti-caste movement, pro-women movement, and that is what today our message we take to the mass of the women in Andhra Pradesh.